Welcome to Spirits Night Silence. I'm Jasmine Ellis. Tonight we are at St. Nicholas Church on the outskirts of Weston-super-Mare here in a place called Uphill. People who walked their dogs at night before going to bed have stated seeing and hearing, which they class is tin miners there on the path by the church. They stated seeing these because on the wall of the tower is a light which shines down on the path and the people can see up. So these are the words that these people who walked the dogs have stated hearing. Blessed Virgin Mary. Joseph was a tin merchant. That Britain is almost the sole land of tin miners. This is what they are stated hearing coming from the church as they're walking their dogs on this hill. So hopefully tonight we may get a glimpse of those tin miners muttering these words.
St. Nicholas Church started to be built on the lower levels, but each night stone was being stolen. The church then opted to build on top of the mould. It took nearly a year to find out the ones who were stealing the stones. Six all in total. Five of the men told on one man. The man was whipped to death, and people have stated seeing this man. But for the five, they were imprisoned for 15 years for helping stealing the stone. So who knows, we may get a glimpse of the one who was whipped to death.
St. Nicholas Church is an old ruin of one half and also a whole church. This is the nave. They only open the church on a few occasions each year when it's important matters like Easter and Christmas. But this is one church that has not been used for burial or for services for quite a lot of years. People have stated here when they are here during the space of the day and also at night where others come and do the paranormal. They have heard moans and groans coming from the nave. There is no actually roof attached to this part of the building, hence the reason why they class it as a ruin. The last people who tried to do a paranormal here did actually ask for permission to go inside at night, but they was refused point blank, so they had to make up do like what we are going to do tonight is stand here and hopefully get some responses here. The reason why behind this that they can hear voices in the church is this. When it was the English Civil War, many prisoners was put in there and they stayed there until actually they died, or if they were still alive at the time when the Civil War was actually finished, they was let out and be freed. So hopefully tonight, who knows, we may get some sounds coming from the nave. There's also a story related to a grave digger. Now, people here are stated seeing the grave digger. The story has it that he came here on one night and dug up graves. People said that it must have been the soul of shamefulness inside him that made him do something that was way out of ordinary for this person. He actually took every skeleton head and all the bones and piling them up neatly behind a grave. The shame that he must have put himself. He died somewhere on this graveyard by the church, and they noticed this person the day after the dirty deed was done. And until a search was carried out, they noticed a grave that was actually dug. And behind that gravestone was the pile of skeleton heads as well as the bones, with the resting place of one grave. Nobody knows why only one grave on that night was dug. No one understands the reason why all these skeleton heads and bones was actually in this graveyard, what was actually dug up. People have seen him walking around. They say he is crying, but they also stated seeing where he lay with an axe and a spade. When he vanishes, so does the axe and spade. So, who knows if there is a graveyard digger here late at night, but we're hoping tonight to find out for ourselves. Besides all the spirits, what people have seen at night, they've also stated seeing a monk walking these grounds, and also three women. One woman is in a red dress with a white bonnet. It seems she is folding her hands, but when they say that they actually see what she is holding, it's like a mitten that you can put your arms through to keep your hands warm. The other two women seems to be much older than the lady. They said that one woman who is dressed in black with a white apron. They say that she is standing on one of these graves, looking down, praying. The other one is mainly over there by the windows
of the church. They say she is peering through the window. Hopefully tonight we may get the glimpse of the three women. Well, if you remember rightly, a few months ago we went to Green Down Fort, which is just over there. You have the river and the mouth runs into the sea. The island that we walked a mile and a half to the fort was over there, and apparently what people stated, seeing the monk around this area, and he is actually looking out towards Green Down Fort. Why is this monk here? Again, nobody understands why there was ever a monk here. But some states, because Glastonbury is just over 20 miles away, that he used to come here and he used to go to Glastonbury Abbey. That's the only explanation that anybody can actually say about this monk. Another story states to him that he was a man who lived here in Weston-super-Mare, and he used to just come here when he felt lonely. Loneliness back then, being a monk, was nothing that anybody can actually put their minds together. Loneliness was not a word back then being used. But here, he must have found peace in himself and closer to God. And people believe this is the reason why that he is here, because he believes this was once his home. Well, tonight it's gonna go two ways. We're either gonna get quite a lot of activity or we will not. Hence the reason why it's called Spirits Night Silence. Really, matter of speaking, the reason why we are in this corner is there is a man and a woman walking around here in the open by this stone, grey stone, and the surrounding stones. They're just walking. People say you can hear them talk to one another. This here, they have stated that the spirits here, the man and woman, spends quite a lot of time. You can get a real description of the two. They say the man himself is actually in a top hat and tails, and the woman, they say, is dressed in a long gown and it floats out like the petticoat that I showed you when we was at Nanny Castle. As they are walking, her dress is swirling around, but they turn around and say some part, that one part of the grave, they disappear.
Is this the grape? Did it disappear? Or is it one of the others close by? We may just get a glimpse of the gentleman and the lady. The woman who's been seen standing by the window is this window here. They say that she's looking through and she just disappears. But when they actually come to see what she was looking at, there is actually nothing inside. Even though it's a church and it is being used a couple of times a year, whoever would like to come to look inside, there is actually nothing in there. It's just plain walls. As you can see, this used to be one of the doors which they stoned up so people again cannot just nilly-dilly walk in and have a look around. The actual door to this place is actually over on the nave, where they gate it off with a nice big padlock. The actual door is over that side to get in to this part. Besides that, all the doors has been walled up. So, happy hauntings, everyone. Thank you.